My name is Anthony Fernandez. I am a dermatologist at Cleveland Clinic in Cleveland, Ohio, where I serve as the Director of Medical Dermatology and the WD Steck Chair of Clinical Dermatology. What is psoriasis? Psoriasis is a very common chronic inflammatory disease that most commonly affects the skin, but it can affect other organ systems. It's been estimated that up to 3% of the entire world has psoriasis. And it can present on the skin looking like different types of skin lesions, but it most commonly presents with red raised skin lesions that have overlying thick silvery white scale. And you can think about the surface area of your palm, including the thumb, as roughly being about 1% of your body surface area. So anything less than 3% body surface area involvement is mild psoriasis, 3 to 10% is moderate psoriasis, and anything more than 10% or 10 palms worth of psoriasis categorizes as severe in nature. What are some treatment options for mild psoriasis? We want to stay conservative, so we usually start with topical medications, medications that you rub on your skin, and those come in different forms. There can be ointments, those look like Vaseline in consistency. There can be creams, they can be lotions, and especially when psoriasis is on the scalp, we use solutions or shampoos. And the most common medications that we prescribe topically are corticosteroids. And there are many different corticosteroids that we can prescribe for our patients topically, and these vary in their strengths or potency. And then there are also some non-steroid medications. These include calcineurin inhibitors like tacrolimus, vitamin D analogs like calcipotriene. And then there are several newer topical medications, tapinarof and roflumilast, that work to control inflammation in a unique way compared to any medications that we've had before it. When topical medications are not entirely effective, then we'll often talk to them about adding phototherapy or light therapy. We'll have them come to our offices and stand in light booths. And the most common type of light that we provide them to help treat psoriasis is narrowband UVB light. UV light in the B range has more effectiveness at controlling psoriasis, and at the same time, we minimize the damage that light exposure causes to the skin. What are some treatment options for moderate to severe psoriasis? When it comes to having moderate to severe psoriasis, we really focus our conversations on systemic medications, which are either pills or biologic medications that are given either as a self-injection or infused through an IV. And we focus our conversation on these systemic medications for several reasons. The more body surface area that is involved with psoriasis, the harder it is to apply topical medications. But more importantly, we know that patients who have moderate to severe psoriasis really have a systemic inflammatory disease. This is not just a skin rash or a skin disease. In other words, for patients with moderate to severe psoriasis, if we draw their blood and we examine the inflammatory molecules in the blood, they're significantly elevated compared to patients who do not have moderate to severe psoriasis. And we think these elevated systemic molecules contribute to risk of developing a number of important comorbid conditions. We want to resolve that systemic inflammation. And by doing so, we hope that we are decreasing risk that these patients develop other important comorbid diseases over time. With that being said, when it comes to talking to patients about the pills that are available, there are really two broad categories. We have our traditional pills that have been around for several decades. Those include methotrexate, cyclosporine, and acitretin. And then we have several newer pills that we call small molecule inhibitors, apremilast and deucravacitinib. And then we also talk to our patients about biologic medications. There are a wide variety of biologic medications that are available. In fact, since 2004, there have been about 10 to 12 biologic medications that have been approved to treat moderate to severe psoriasis. And these can broadly be categorized based on what those medications block in the inflammatory environment of psoriasis. And they include TNF-alpha inhibitors, interleukin-12-23 inhibitors, interleukin-17 inhibitors, and interleukin-23 inhibitors. What chronic conditions are associated with psoriasis? There is a wealth of research over the past several decades supporting that patients with psoriasis, especially moderate to severe psoriasis, are at increased risk for developing coronary artery disease, congestive heart failure, peripheral arterial disease, even high blood pressure. And they're also at significantly increased risk for having heart attacks and strokes. Patients with psoriasis are also at increased risk for developing numerous other chronic inflammatory diseases, such as psoriatic arthritis, which is a type of inflammatory arthritis that's estimated to affect 20 to 30% of all patients who have psoriasis. They're at increased risk for developing inflammatory bowel disease, which includes Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. And they're at increased risk for developing psychiatric conditions, most commonly depression and anxiety. And how we treat those really depends on what conditions the patients develop. We want to make sure that they're being treated with medications that are well known to be effective for whatever condition they have, and at the same time maintain control of their psoriasis. What should you do if you suspect you have psoriasis? If you believe that you may have psoriasis, the most important thing to do is to contact your physician, either your primary care physician or a dermatologist, and schedule an appointment and let those physicians evaluate your rash, and they can better help you determine whether or not it's psoriasis.